Welcome to Using Census Data with Excel. I'm Adam Heckman. In this module, we're going to look at data analysis. There's some very simple ways to create very quick and effective analyses in Excel. Later, we're going to talk about more advanced data analysis, but in this case, we'll focus on some easy ways to quickly derive insights from census data. New to Excel 2019 is something called data types. With data types, you can get more specific geography data. Geography is a data type, so I'll click on the state and data and choose the geography data type. And it's considered a linked data type because what it does is it brings you information from online data sources on your geography into your workbook. So this allows me to bring back very rich, interesting information that I can work with and refresh later. Now you'll notice that when I chose geography, there's a little icon that was added to the states. This tells me that this column has data from an outside data source, and if I click on Show Card, I can see more information on, in this case, the state of Illinois. There's the seal, talks about the elected leaders, some demographic data, some economic data, population data, things of that nature. And so this is a very easy way to get rich data into your spreadsheets. There's also data types for stocks, and there's more coming soon. Now, with a table like this, with year-over-year data, it's very useful to see to look at trends. You can certainly create a line chart that shows you the trend for each state, but with 50 states here, there's probably some better ways to see the trends for any particular state right in the spreadsheet itself, and this is where sparklines come in handy. Sparklines are like little charts that live inside a single cell and that can be used to visually represent and show a trend in your data. Sparklines can draw attention to important items, in this case population changes, and we can also use them to highlight the minimum and maximum values in a row. Now I can click on Insert and insert sparklines from the sparklines section, or I can click anywhere in my table and hit Control Q, which gives me the shortcut for a lot of quick analysis tools, one of them being sparklines. So I can choose the type of sparkline I want. I have line charts, column charts, and what's called winner-loss charts. But since I'm looking at trends, I'm just going to choose the line chart here. So this placed the sparkline in a new column, and we can call that column Trend. And now I can very quickly, at a glance for each state, see how that population is trending for the last 3 years. So here you're only looking at 3 years worth of data. Imagine you were looking at a decade or more of data. Sparklines can tell you a lot at a glance. Now you can quickly see the trend for each state, and that's a lot of great insight in a single cell, but it's also very useful to see where are the highs and where are the lows. To make that more obvious, what I can do is click on the sparkline tab on my ribbon. I can say, tell me the high point and tell me the low point, and I can change the marker color so that the high point is a different color from the low point. Let's make the high point green and the low point red. And now you can very easily see the high points and the low points. And again, this is only one of the chart options that you can use with sparklines. When I hit Control Q before, you probably noticed that sparklines weren't alone here. There's a number of quick analysis tools in addition to sparklines. In fact, quick analysis tools provides you a trove of insights that you can add to your census data. You can instantly create different types of charts, including line charts and column charts and stack charts. You can also go back and apply table styles. And in our case, what I'd like to do here is choose data bars so I can see data visualization within the cells themselves. So here I can compare the populations for each state. And you'll notice here, California is very big, so the bar is very long. And other states like Maine or Montana are not so heavily populated, so their bar is shorter. There's a number of other quick analysis tools that you can play around with, like the icon set and the tables, etc. go ahead and play around with these and see what is useful for your types of analysis that you're doing with census data.